When I was a child, I spent a lot of time thinking on my own. There was a huge oak tree in our backyard, and I used to sit and the wind always blew, so the thing was moving all the time. And I used to think about all sorts of things about life and how things worked. I became trained by a chemist, and I was doing a postdoc on the NIH campus. I was sequencing genes. I realized very quickly that you cannot do that without a computer. So I started learning how to use a computer, how to set up computers, how to expand computers to deal with bigger amounts of data, and soon became the expert in the lab on computational biology methods. The research I'm doing now is about turning genes on and off. And in order to do that, we need to analyze very large data sets. And to analyze large data sets, we use software that we develop to process the data on significant computers. Our research is more designed around what the natural process is in the cell. Things in the nucleus are not flat. The chromosomes fold into chromatin, and the chromatin itself folds into higher structures. And all these are in some sort of flux at all times. So when they become used for upregulation or downregulation to create more of a protein, all of that is one big concert of events taking place to create or suppress a different function. Our work on the natural process of biology acts as a foundation for clinicians, geneticists, and physicians to try and understand what happens in people that get sick. You have to have an imagination. If you don't have an imagination, it's hard to do science. I think I'll always be this curious, and I'll turn it up again when my grandchildren can be challenged with these questions. The beauty of handing the curiousness over to the next generation is very important. But I'm looking forward to the time that I can walk around the field and explain to them things that they never thought of and make them more curious.